urine retention, it's all in your head. Now, I'm talking about urine retention, not urine incontinence. This is the inability to release your urine, not the opposite, okay? Not the ability to hold your urine. Urine retention, you're holding your urine, you can't release it, you can't pee it out. So you get full, you get bloated, you get abdominal pressure, and over time that actually causes damage to your kidneys, and you have kidney failure, kidney problems, and filtration, all this stuff from your kidney, right? So you wanna look to your head. You wanna use your hands, and you wanna go to the top of your head from both sides, and you wanna connect the dots, and this is where you would push. You'll push this on top of your head about 1 inch all around. You just want to massage, okay? This reestablishes the connection between your brain and your bladder so that it relaxes your bladder so that your bladder can release the urine so that you don't retain the urine and you can actually pee it out, all right? Follow me.
Hi, my name is Tasha and I'm 40 years old and I'm a patient here at Yin Acupuncture. I originally came in for acupuncture because I was experiencing excruciating pelvic pain related to uterine fibroids that I'd been diagnosed with. So since I've been coming here, I originally started in August of 2011, and after my first full month of treatment, I've been completely pain-free. I've been doing the acupuncture and the herbs as well, and it's now February of 2012, and I'm still completely pain-free. I would absolutely recommend acupuncture, Yin Acupuncture. Mr. Yin and his staff, they're wonderful, they're caring, they're committed to overall well-being. So acupuncture is definitely a go for me, especially at the beginning as maybe was a little bit of a skeptic, but now that I've seen my progress and I'm pain-free, I would absolutely recommend. Thank you.
Alright, happy Friday everybody. Jimmy Yen from Achieve Integrative Health, your neurology acupuncture specialist. And today's Friday, so Friday we're gonna go over Foodie Friday. Foodie Friday, we're gonna go over the herb. It's in Chinese, it's called Fuling. And English is called Poria, or even called Indian bread. I didn't realize it was called Indian bread. Actually, when they cut it, it looks like a piece of bread. It's like a white bread. But it's called Poria and Indian bread. And so what are the actions of Poria and Indian bread? It's basically, it has a diuretic function. So if you have water retention, like your legs get swollen, so like teachers and nurses, they get their legs get super swollen, well, you can have it add a diuretic to actually help reduce that swelling, that water retention. It can also be helpful, because it's a diuretic, it can also be helpful for people who have hypertension. So hypertension, you know, there's a drug that they commonly use, it's called HCTZ, which is a diuretic to help decrease the fluid retention in the arteries, which helps decrease the blood pressure. Poria, Indian bread, can also do the same thing. It's also anti-neoplastic, so it can inhibit cancer cell activity. And that we don't use here in the US because the FDA would slap a little label across, you know, our clinic and close our clinic down if we were to say anything about that. Next thing is, it's a sedative. So Poria or Indian bread can also act as a sedative. It can actually calm your mind and help you promote sleep, okay? And it's also a mild antibiotic, okay? It can help with some types of bacterial infection. But these are mild effects for these. It's mostly used as a diuretic, and also it can also promote digestion, even though I didn't write it here. It can also help promote digestion, but majority of its function is really focused on getting the kidneys, your water organ, which is helps with water metabolism. It's mostly focused on getting your kidneys functioning better, restoring function. So remember, in Chinese medicine, at Achieve Integrative Health, we practice the Emperor's Medicine, which is a restorative medicine. We focus on restoring function and not replacing function. So when you take a Chinese herb, you don't necessarily take it singly. It's always combined with like 20, 30 other herbs. But when you take Chinese herbs, the difference between herbs and supplements you get over-the-counter supplements, they are still there to replace a function in your body. Chinese herbs is not replacing a function in your body, it's actually restoring function. So for a good way to understand this is when you take the supplement or whatever you take, after you stop, let's assume that everything over the counter works, okay? If everything works, you take it and it works. What happens when you stop taking it? Does your body go back? Does your body start failing? Does the function start failing? You know, or does the function of the organ sustain and maintain without whatever you took? That's the key to restorative medicine. Restorative medicine is when you take it, it helps you, and then when you stop taking it, your body continues to do it by itself. Replacement functions, basically you take it and it helps you, you stop taking it, all your symptoms come back, you feel like crap again. So that's a replacing of function in your body. So today, Poria Indian bread, it's very good for diuretics. So people with hypertension, diabetes, nurses, teachers, people that stand a lot, swell up in the ankles a lot, kidney problems, Poria is actually a super great herb. And we actually use it to cook. So a lot of Chinese herbs are food. So we cook them in our food and we make a soup out of it. And that soup, you know, tastes actually pretty good. All right, guys. So that's the food of today, Poria Indian bread. Give it a try. Cook it. Okay, you can cook it maybe in your chicken soup. Okay, put it in your chicken soup. It's very tasty. So as always, remember, this is Jimmy Yen from Achieve Integrative Health. Achieve Integrative Health here in Cedar Park, the number one acupuncture and wellness clinic in Central Texas. And we are here to help and serve you, whether it be Chinese herbs or other, but we do restorative medicine. So as always, remember, everything in life is achievable, but it's up to us to make it happen. So it's a Friday. Let's go out this weekend and let's start planning and let's start doing and let's start making stuff happen.